It's been a while. Many things have changed, so we got a lot of catching up to do. A week from tomorrow, you will step inside of the Elimination Chamber for the very first time in your career. Once you found out you earned your right to compete in the Elimination Chamber, what was your initial reaction?
Almost a little bit surreal. You know, the Elimination Chamber is something that I had on my bucket list that I've always wanted to compete in. I actually remember being 14 years old, and at the time we still had the VCR-DVD combo.
And ooh, I went, yeah. You were living in the tall grass there.
Yeah. Good combo. So at the time, VHS tapes were a little bit cheaper than DVDs. So I was able to get my hands on the Survivor Series 2002 VHS. And I remember watching that first chamber very fondly. So ever since then, it's something that I've wanted to do.
Well, let me ask you this. Why is Bronson Reed prepared now to make a mark on WWE, beginning inside the Elimination Chamber, versus the last time we spoke?
I think now more than ever, I have a big chip on my shoulder. You know, I did spend that little time away, and if anything, it's just hardened me as a competitor more than ever. You know, I got to spend a lot of time in Japan and really test not only like my wrestling skills, but my will and how much I want to still pursue and chase this. And it kept me grounded in that I love professional wrestling and I always want to be that. And I wound up back here with the WWE. So I'm not going to let any opportunity pass me by.
So I want to take it back to the Elimination Chamber, which is obviously an opportunity you've been wanting for quite some time. You're going to be in there with a lot of guys you are familiar with. Your Gargano, as we look around the rest of the field, guys at Theory who has spent time in NXT. But the one name that stands out to me is Seth freaking Rollins. What does it mean to you, Bronson Reed, having been a passionate performer and traveled many of the same paths as these guys? We've all, you know, all culminates in the Elimination Chamber. What does it mean to you to be in there with somebody at the level of Seth Rollins for the very first time?
Yeah, you know, I love always, again, testing myself against, you know, the biggest names in the business. I'm not, you know, I'm 340 pounds. I'm a big dude. I'm someone that gets in there and destroys people. But somehow I feel like sometimes I'm still the underdog in people's eyes. I don't know if it's because I haven't done certain things or, you know, I do come from Australia. Sometimes I get a little bit of a bad rep. But I'm no underdog. Wait,
you, people don't like you because you're Australian? Is that a real problem?
No. Not Australian per se, but I feel like the wrestling world and even some of the people in the wrestling world don't give Australia the respect it deserves when it comes to pro wrestling. We have a rich history in our country. Yeah. I think people forget the history that the country has in wrestling and they think it's a bit like, oh, maybe these guys, you know, they don't know what they're doing sort of thing. But that's not it. Yeah. So, I definitely want to test myself against Seth Rollins because whenever I'm in there with someone of his caliber, it just brings out the best in me. And I prove to all those people that I'm there for a reason.
I love that. I can get that sense. You mentioned the chip on your shoulder. I can get that sense about you now, you know, and you've had a lot of experience in this game. But I do need to know, who is Bronson Reed, right? We've seen how devastating you can be, but what's going on inside the mind of Bronson Reed? Tell us more about Bronson.
Well, you know, I think Bronson, when I arrived to NXT, it was about the journey. It was about, you know, all those years that I sacrificed away from my wife and family and leaving my home country to be able to get to WWE. Now coming back, I think is a little bit of a different story. Like I said, I have that chip on my shoulder. I don't really care what anyone thinks. I'm there to get what I want done. I want to be a champion. I want to be a main event guy. Like, so I'll do whatever it takes to get those spots.
Give us a primer for Monday night. Mustafa Ali's been talking a big game, hasn't he? He's been all up in your ear and you showed up and you were dressed to the nines. I mean, gravy, the suit that Bronson was rocking on Monday night, the look that
you had. I respect a man with style, no doubt about it.
Mighty impressive. Mustafa Ali, Monday night, you're going to put him in his place?
Oh, 100%. You know, I think Ali is a great competitor. He's someone that can do amazing things in the ring, but he always, you know, puts his foot in his own mouth, and you can't be talking that sort of trash backstage when you got guys like me walking around. We're great white sharks in the sea. He's just a little fish that's about to get eaten up.
Great whites, fish getting eaten. You can tell he's Australian. Talk to me, Bronson. I was expecting Kevin Patrick to go there because we discussed it in the pre-production meeting. Talk to me about your Australian pride. I didn't think it was going to be much of a talking point, but you brought it up yourself. You've got Rhea Ripley, who's going to headline WrestleMania against Charlotte Flair. You've got yourself. You've got Grayson Waller, who just headlined NXT inside a cage with Braun Breaker. How does it make you feel seeing your people represented on such a grand scale, and not only just being represented, but succeeding?
Yeah, not just Aussie pride too. It's Adelaide pride for you, boy. All right?
Yeah, exactly. Rhea, yeah, Adelaide. Yeah, me and Rhea both from the same hometown. Again, it's one of those hometowns that gets a little bit crapped on in Australia because it's one of the smaller ones. So to see both of us being so successful is incredible. But for me, yeah, I love where I came from, and I also love Australian professional wrestling. I was around it for so long. That's where I got trained. That's where I got brought up. I ended up training a whole generation of wrestlers that are down there as well. So I want that representation on screen for those guys to see, hey, we can be successful. We can chase this. We can do this. And me growing up, I didn't really have that. So I think it's a very important thing.
You weren't a big Outback Jack guy?
No, not really. You know, the closest thing I had was the Bushwhackers, but they were from New Zealand, but good enough.
Close enough. You guys don't claim New Zealand until it's convenient. And you're like, yeah. Oh yeah, the whole, you know, that whole region. Where, you know.
Yeah, if they're successful, we'll take them on. You know,
we'll claim them. I love it.
I just love what you said there about training others though too. And you see this so much, Gravy. We talk about it. And whether it's, you know, Finn Balor training Becky Lynch from her early days over in Ireland, and you're talking about training some of the younger superstars that are emerging over in Australia right now, just clearly shows your love for this business that you're part of.
Yeah, I've loved professional wrestling since I could remember. My earliest memories of life, crazily enough, watching WrestleMania 2. So there's nothing else I'd be doing in this world other than this, but yeah, it makes me very proud to see those guys in Australia doing well and coming up. Even people like Grayson Waller, who sort of came in a bit after me, and now he's headlining NXT. Like, it's incredible. Actually, Rhea Ripley used to come to live shows and watch me in the crowd as a fan, and then years later, as soon as she started wrestling, I'm like, okay, she's gonna be, you know, on TV. I could see straight away she's incredible. And now she's, yeah, WrestleMania headliner. Like, it's incredible.
I can't wait till the headlines that Bronson Reed takes credit for all of Rhea Ripley's success.
Yeah, well, if it wasn't for me, you know, showing how it's done, you know, maybe she wouldn't get here. I don't know.
Like what you hear? Catch full episodes of After the Bell wherever you get your podcasts. Follow us now and never miss an episode.